When we look at the different kinds of breast cancer, the invasive breast cancers, there are fundamentally two types, invasive ductal and invasive lobular. Now, the invasive ductal makes up about 85% of cancers, and the invasive lobular makes up the 15%, roughly, of the other type of invasive cancers. Now, in general, they'll occur separately, but the question that's been proposed is, can they occur together? And the answer is yes. Theoretically, the invasive lobular is farther out the branch on the tree, if you will, out in the lobules that make milk, and the invasive ductal is arising from the ductal system heading out toward the nipple. The actual origin of breast cancer is probably in a little off-branching, if you will, of the duct called the terminal ductal lobular unit. So theoretically, then, the cancers, either type, can arise from the TDLU. Now, what impact does this have on treatment? Well, as you've heard me say many times, we want to always know about the extent of disease. The extent of disease is measured usually by physical exam, measured by mammogram, measured by ultrasound, and also measured by MRI. There are many of us, including myself, who believe that any patient diagnosed with invasive lobular needs a breast MRI to help us further define the extent of the disease. Now, as far as treatment difference, including having both invasive cancers together, there's really no treatment difference. Data exists that shows that lumpectomy works very well in invasive lobular cancer, and clearly it does in invasive ductal. So while it may be unusual to have both cancers together in the same breast, the treatment should fundamentally be the same. If a person is a candidate for breast conservation, the fact we have the two together should not deter that decision to do lumpectomy and radiation therapy. And conversely, if the patient is choosing a mastectomy or needs a mastectomy, again, there's no contraindications. So to sort of come full circle, it's true that having both together is not very common, but really should not impact treatment decisions. And as I've said multiple times, please make sure you're working with qualified providers. Hopefully you're working with a multidisciplinary team. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.